We're breeding a better bean. Now we're doing this by breeding beans which have increased drought tolerance, so they need less irrigation, increased pest resistance, so they need less insecticides, and increased productivity, so you can get more beans produced on the same amount of acreage, while at the same time maintaining all the nutritional value and all the wonderful taste components that beans already have.
We have a project that was recently funded by the USDA to look at the diversity of wild beans, but also to see in which environment they actually grow. And particularly, we are interested in identifying wild beans that grow in warmer and drier areas. We suspect that those wild beans are actually probably more tolerant to drought.
So we're crossing wild beans to a domesticated bean and trying to figure out what are the genetics that control the drought tolerance. And if and we suppose that that beans that come from dry places will be more drought tolerant, but we have to prove that.
The water status is going to be very much uncertain. We know that with climate change, temperature is certainly going to rise by 3 to 4 degrees. In terms of rainfall, it's going to become much more irregular than what we had before. So we have to prepare varieties that are able to deal both with normal rainfall, but also with drought. I think that you want anything, any human activity, you want to make it more efficient. And that involves agriculture also. If you can grow the same amount of beans with less water, that is a big contribution.